point of weary? Is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? Cause shame's done all this stealing, and you're desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you.
So it's a very important thing that we forgive So this is my story, my testimony. We fell in love while working in a tobacco field. We were high school sweethearts. We both went to church all of our lives. We were saved as young teenagers. We got married right out of high school in 1971. Some of you don't remember that. But anyway, 2 years after marriage, we started our little family. 4 years later, we had another little girl, Deanna Lee and Dina Kay Richardson. Deanna was 4 and Dina was 10 months old. February the 22nd, 1979, our lives were changed forever. There was a greedy man by the name of Whitehead in Myrtle Beach that wanted a coin collection that did not belong to him. So he hired 2 men, Scar and Wimmer. These 2 people went to Collington County and stole the coin collection and killed the owner of the coin collection. They decided that morning when they left Myrtle Beach that anybody they came in contact with that day, they would kill just for the fun of it. On the way back to Myrtle Beach, they stopped at a house that we were renting on Highway 17A while my childhood home was being renovated to be our forever home. They picked the rental house we were in to stop and have some demonic fun. I had a sister that was living with us. I left early that afternoon to take Dina, the youngest, to the sitter's house. My sister, Lee, my husband, and my 4-year-old, Deanna, were home. Lee had the day off. I was working the afternoon shift at the box plant. While I'm doing my job and thinking the world was perfect, great, these 2 men stopped at our rental home for no apparent reason than to do demonic evil. They robbed my husband and killed him. They killed my sister, and they left my 4-year-old daughter for dead. They thought she was dead. They leave there, they go on their merry way and go to Polly's Island at a convenience store and kidnap 2 women. They rape these 2 women and kill them, so they think. There was a survivor, Miss Wanda Summers. All this time, I'm at work thinking the world is beautiful. My sister Eleanor finds out what has happened because my 4-year-old that fainted when she saw the guns, she came to and she had to push her daddy off of her. 4 years old, she is thinking that her aunt and her daddy are asleep and she tries to wake them up. She then realizes they're not going to wake up. So she knows she has to get help. So after trying to crank her daddy's truck and realizes that was not going to work, she hops on her bicycle on a winter day at approximately 4:30 or 5 o'clock to ride a little over 4 miles on her little bike with training wheels to her aunt's house. She passed many other houses on the way, but she didn't stop. And I asked her one time, I said, Deanna, what do you think you didn't stop until you got to Aunt Eleanor's house? There had been a snowstorm and our heat went out, so we had to go to my sister's house to have heat, and we spent the night there probably a week or 2 weeks before this happened. So she said she thinks that's why she went. She didn't stop anywhere else. She just made it to her aunt's house. so my sister Eleanor comes to my job and tells me my world as I know it was no more. She tells me that my husband and my sister have been shot. And I could stand here all night and never be able to explain to you all the thoughts, the fear, the loneliness, the devastation, the hurt, the questions, and on I could go. I'm asking God, why did you let this happen? My husband, who always had a smile on his face, my sister, they never hurt anyone. Why did you let this happen to them, to me, to our girls? For months, I was very angry at God for allowing this to happen. I was in a big valley of trouble, as my pastor had preached about a few Sundays before I gave my testimony. I needed that gateway of hope, 360 degrees, that he brought out in that message. Thank God I had my family, my friends, and my church family praying for me. In time, I understood Romans 8 and 28. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for those who are called according to his purpose. I'm here to tell you tonight, God does not make mistakes. He always sees the big picture while we can only see that little 4x6 that's in front of us. Lee had a cousin that he loved very much. Randy got saved and became a minister. Rusty Bloomer got saved in prison before his execution. There's an article on the internet under his name, Ronald Rusty Bloomer, that I would encourage everyone to pull up and read. The first time that I heard about Rusty's salvation, I was going to work one morning and I was running a little bit late and I had my radio on, the Christian radio station. And Chuck Olson came on and he was going to talk about prison ministry. And I knew before he said it that he was going to talk about Rusty Bloomer. And he did, and he talked about him getting saved in prison. And I'm like, yeah, right, sure, you know. I went home that afternoon after work, and I asked my husband then, Harold Dupree, I said, told him about the radio, what I'd heard on it. And I said, how in the world can God let this man to kill these people go to heaven and be up there with them? And he said, Janice, he said, you have to understand, if this man really and truly asked God for forgiveness, God forgive him. And he said, when he goes to heaven, he's not going to remember what he did to Lee and my sister. They're not going to remember what he did to them. It's heaven. If you remembered all that stuff, it couldn't be heaven, could it? But he told me that, and I said, okay, I accepted that. And then after my pastor asked me to give my testimony, I was sitting on my back porch, and I decided, hey, I'm going to look Ronald Rusty Bloomer up and see what I can find. And there was his testimony. And I cried. And there was no doubt in my mind that that man was not saved. So I encourage you to pull it up and read it, and it will truly help you. It's well well worth the read. As I said, God is an amazing God, in case you did not know, and he never makes mistakes. Yes, I forgave him during the process of getting over being angry with God. I forgave Ronald Rusty Wilmer. I had to. I didn't want what he did to my family to eat away at me like a cancer and cause me to raise my children thinking you don't have to forgive people for the wrongful acts that they commit to you and your family. If you don't forgive, it only hurts you and people that you come in contact with when they realize the bitterness and the hatred that you have in your heart. I have a dear friend that said she actually hated Mr. Wilmer for what he did to my family. But she said after she heard my testimony, she knew she had to forgive him, and so she did. She realized that if I had forgiven him, she could too. I don't know how many other people were helped out of that big valley of trouble because of what happened on February the 22nd, 1979. But I believe with all my heart, I will meet them in heaven one day soon. 3 years after this horrible tragedy, I met a man, Harold Dupree, through his sister that I fell in love with, and we got married in 1985. And he helped me raise my girls. I thank God for allowing me to have him in my life and in my girls' lives. And thank y'all so much.